And that's the other thing that I preach. It's funny, the corollaries between nutrition and business, which is in finding success, you have to be introspective and you have to constantly self-assess in order to be successful in business, which is what my, which is my thing. And so I find nutritionally and getting in shape, those two things are interconnected in a lot of ways, because mindset is everything. Down on yourself, who's responsible for it? I didn't do it. They did. It's their fault. I'm exhausted. I can't do anymore. And, you know, you've only worked a 10-hour day. All of those kind of the excuses that you make for yourself, why you're not successful, why you didn't get promoted, why you haven't moved forward, why you haven't started your own company, you know, all of the, if not for, I could have, I think really translates into the nutrition and the diet and the exercise side also.
Oh, without a doubt. It's mindset's everything. You kind of alluded to this before when we were talking about meal prep and eating every 2 hours and seven times a day, and we don't sustain that. But if it was really that easy, we could all download a meal plan off of the internet and follow it and get right where we need to be. A trainer can, you can buy one, you can have a trainer monitor you. And if it was really just about discipline and it was really that easy, we'd be able to do that. But yet clearly we don't. Right. And the reason is, again, like I said, emotion overrides logic. It is a lot between the 6 inches right here between your ears about the game of the endurance of weight loss. But really, it's the emotional side to this. We are guaranteed hard things. You've alluded to has been some hard stuff in your business in the last year. This economy and this past year has been bananas. And when emotions hit, we can turn to any number of things to make us feel better. There's this thing called the feeling spectrum. Like picture your left hand and it was going to touch a hot stove. You take it off because it's too hot. And so that's extreme pain. And over here, your right hand, that might be you're putting your hand on the feeling of Christmas morning or when you eat that bite of chocolate, and it doesn't sustain either. It doesn't last, but that's extreme happiness. Now, when we're having pain over here on the left hand, there are any number of things we can do. Our body wants us to feel happy again. There's any number of things, and society will frown on them. Stealing, gambling, drugs, driving too fast. Any number of those types of things, we could do them. They would give us an endorphin rush. But since we're like, people snub that, we're a little less likely to do it. But when it comes to overeating, that's like okay to do.
Yeah.
So when you feel stress, uncertainty, anxiety, somebody got sick, died, relationships, jobs tough, whatever that pain is you're feeling, your body still wants to protect you and get you away from it. So one way you can do this is overeating with whatever that food is, the pretzels, the chocolate chips, the ice cream, the French fries. What does happen is while you're eating, you are numbed out from that. It's like a blanket went over that tension or that pain. And it feels really good to not have to think about that for a little bit or feel that. It feels good. And then the endorphins from the food feel good. And that's our body keeping us safe. The problem is the food's finite. You're getting to the bottom of the ice cream. You're going to get to the bottom of the chip bag. And then what'll happen is blood sugar will go up and down. And eventually that numb that's covering up the pain, that numb is going to go away and you're going to be left with the pain. And now we're going to have this feeling of regret. Your stomach's going to hurt. And if you're looking to lose weight, you're going to wake up the next morning back in that shame spiral and discouragement of, I undid all my hard work. So when we can talk about this thing is emotional, we do need to address, what are you emotionally hungry for? Like, why were we turning to carbs? I mean, and carbs taste delicious. I agree. But why are we turning to them to make things better for us? What is the better? What do we need? Do we have an email that's uncomfortable to write? Did a kid just get all squirrely in the house and we got some bad news? Did finance, did something happen with the job? Like, are we emotionally hungry for comfort? Are we feeling tired, bored? Those are all bad feelings. Are we stressed? That has a lot more to do with the food sabotaging, because otherwise we'd be able to follow the food list off of the internet.
Right. I think that the introspection and the self-assessment and the discipline that it takes feeds off of itself. And for me, how I would interpret what you just said and how I'm able to stick to doing what I want to do is that I'm very analytical. So in my brain, spending the time at the gym 2 hours every morning, two and a half hours this morning, the way that I have been, and I've been very consistent, and I'm, like I said, I'm recording it and making sure that at least for me, I'm putting it out there. So I'm holding myself accountable. My diet guaranteed today will be 100% spot on, and guaranteed tomorrow will be 100% spot on. And then if I don't go to the gym for some reason, I'm not so certain that I'm going to sit here and tell you that my diet's going to be 100% spot on, because it's weird the way my brain works, and I'm the most disciplined human being you'll ever meet. But if I don't go to the gym, I can justify, because I'm not screwing up all those calories that I worked so hard to burn off this morning. So I'm going to eat a burrito. But if I go to the gym, now I'm sitting here going, no, I got to drink my eggs and my protein because I put all that work in, and I'm not just going to piss all that work away. That psychology is exactly inverse of what you would expect it to be. But again, through assessing how I feel, being honest with myself about how I feel, I can then battle those days where I go, okay, I got to be in Seattle tonight. I can't go to the gym. I'm going to be in a car all day long. I'm going to do what I'm supposed to. I'm going to eat what I'm supposed to. And I mentally then have that fight with myself to make sure I hold myself accountable. But it's really interesting for me, and I wonder if not most people are like that. Because going to the gym's it has a cost. You know, you got to get up early, and you have to sweat, and you got to work and push yourself and all of those things that go with it. And I think for me, that cost is that I don't want to lose it on the other side by eating.